Hi guys, this video is to explain the functionality of eForms in Panther. eForms could be used by the experts to share any information with the user at the time of consulting the user or at the time when the consultation is done. For instance, for a platform which is of a telemedicine use case, if a user is getting a consultation from a doctor, at the end of the session or at the end of the consultation, the doctor can send him an e-form in the form of an e-prescription, and he can prescribe the various medicines that is required to be taken from the user. Now let's see how we can set up e-forms. So make sure you are in the admin dashboard. Once you're in the admin dashboard, go to the manage section and go to the conversations part. Once you're in conversations, go to the chat dashboard and scroll down to settings. Once you're in settings, go to add-ons and scroll down to the bottom of add-ons. At the bottom, you will see the option of eForms. So make sure you turn on this toggle to enable eForms in the dashboard. Once this toggle is enabled, you will see the option of eForms here. So as you can see in the eForms window, there are already test templates that have been made by the admin. What you could do is, let me try and create a template for your ready reference. So let's say, assuming that this is we are making an e-form in the form of a prescription. So since this is a template, we'll just copy this template from here and create a new template, which is prescription template. Once the template is created, you could see the various labels that can be added or the various fields that can be added in this e-form. So you have the option to add your own logo, and by default there are few labels here, which is of agent name, agent email, customer name or deep links. You could edit the fields according to your feasibility. So in this current e-form, I do not want deep links. So I simply click on backspace, and that's how I'll be able to delete this field. Instead of agent name, I want the e-form to say doctor name. Doctor email and patient name. So these are the various fields that we have added. Apart from these fields, if you want to add several other fields to the e-form, you have the option to choose from the various labels that are already there, which is agent email, agent number, date. Apart from these pre-created labels, if you wish to create another or a new label, you always have the option to create a new label as well. So let's say the label that I want is for a prescription. Value could be ignored, and field type could be anything. It could be, this field type could be in a text form or a number form, an email form, a date form or a text area. So let's select text area and create this label. Once the label is created, you have to again select, click on the drop down and click on prescription. The prescription field has now been added, but make sure you need to put the field name as well. So prescription is the field name, and prescription that we have just created is the field type of the type of field that we have just created. So once you make this, click on save. And going forward, any expert who's trying to give a consultation will have access to this template, and he could use this template to prescribe medicines to the patient. Now, let's switch to the user dashboard to see how it works. Now I am in the user dashboard, and this is the listing I am trying to consult now. The message pop-up box will open. I say hi. Once I send this message, let's switch to the admin dashboard. So as you can see,
A message has been sent by the user, and you can, as an expert, you can see the message. So, while consulting, the expert has the option to send various, to various saved replies, or to send a bot, or to send a payment request. E-form could be sent from this particular option. Once I click on send e-form, I will have the access to all the e-forms that have been created by the admin. Let's try and send this prescription template too that we have just created. This is the agent name, which is the expert's name, expert's email, customer's name, and the prescription that I will be giving to the user now. Let's say I prescribe. And I send it across to the user. This e-form will be sent in the form of a PDF and will appear something like this. Now let's switch to the user dashboard. So as you can see, this is the PDF that I have just received from the expert. While once you click on it, it will open in the form of a PDF, and on opening, I will be able to see the information that has been passed on by the user, or by the expert, sorry. So that's all about it. Thank you so much for watching the video.